This is one of several chairs I have in my house, and the floor in my house is all porcelain ceramic tile, which is very hard and fairly abrasive. The glide is molded around the head of a nail. There's a bit of softer rubber-like material that goes over that. But to install that, you have to drive that in with a hammer. You can pre-drill a hole in there, but you can't make the hole too big or these will keep falling out. Oftentimes, driving this in will crack that plastic and you can go get another one. And given time, these will wear down and this will crack and break off. It'll crack and break off and all you have left is this piece of rubber. You got to carefully pry that nail out of there and try to get another one to stay in there. Not all of these chairs are used that frequently, but of the ones that are used, I end up replacing this about once a year. Drilled some test holes in a piece of plywood. The 1 1/16 hole fits on there just right and extends about 3/4 inch up the leg. This plywood is Baltic birch. It's a little under 1/4 inch thick. It's metric. A 1 3/16 hole fits on there flush with the bottom of the leg. 1 5/16 goes up there too far. A 1 1/4 inch hole goes up about 3/4 inch, which is the same as the front leg. In Fusion 360, I drew a cross section, and this is actually half of a cross section of the cap that will be printed to go on the end of the legs. This little section in here is a support. This piece will be printed upside down on the build plate, and then this piece will be snapped off. I've recessed this a bit down here so it'll be easier to break this off after this is printed. And this center support is needed when it starts filling this in across here. It gives out a better support for printing. This section right here is tapered. Actually, this was originally drawn in inches. So it's actually tapered from 0.531 to 0.54. This was converted to metric, so when I go to Cura, it'll print properly. Now if we get rid of the dimensions, now I'm going to rotate this 360 degrees to make a solid. This will be printed upside down, and this center section will be on the build plate and gives it proper support for printing. And when we get done, I'll reach in here with a pair of pliers and snap this out of here. I broke the center post out of all of these and went in here with a flat Dremel tool and just cleaned up the bottom. I have these on the end of these legs, and this is sitting on top of a table saw, which is pretty flat. Generally, you're not going to find a floor surface that is this flat. With this being a spherical shape, there's only one point of contact with the floor surface. And as these slide back and forth on my ceramic tile floor, which is abrasive, they will grind a flat surface even with the floor, as seen on the glides that were removed. These were printed with 20% infill, and it took 10 or 12 hours to print these four for one chair. And I don't think at 20% infill that these would hold up that well. And if I print these at 100%, it'll take a day and a half or so to print these for one chair. So I intend to make a silicone mold of these and then cast them with the same type resin I used for the conductor And that stuff is tough, and the service life for something like this will be very good. I printed these at 0.1 millimeter layers, and you do have some little ridges and grooves around here, which I filled with epoxy sculpt, and this was some other material I used. And after that's set up, I just chucked this up on the lathe and spun it and sanded it smooth. And I needed some indexing points, and these are the ends off of some ink pens that I glued to this foam core board. But I still have a hole in here, so using some of Aline's tacky glue, put a little bit of that on the end of that, and a little bit underneath the head of these small nails. I use a magnetic bit, and that just pushes down into that foam board. Wipe off the excess, and once that is dried, that will keep the silicone from going down in there. This is a faster way of doing this than trying to build this mold box up with clay. Silicone was cast on the first mold and the form removed, and now I'm getting ready to cast the second side. Each of these glides will have a vent, and the resin will be poured into the center, goes down, fills that cavity, and the air escapes out through the vent. And all these indexing points align the mold, so everything's in alignment when you get ready to put it back together. Cut the points off of these, and I cut one corner off the mold so you know which way to go together. There's a lot of similarity here. I will make a separate video on casting the chair glides. The casting process became a bit more complicated than expected, and there's quite a bit of information there. Including that here will just make this video too long. A chair leg is nothing more than a dowel, and that dowel comes down and is hitting about like so, and these caps for glides are meant to fit onto the bottom of the leg, and it sits like that. And putting construction adhesive in the bottom and putting it up on the leg and turning it, pull it off again, see if I get a good contact pattern, put it on there, and then let it sit. Do a front leg. And that's making good contact with that. Five of the six chairs sit flat on this table saw. This chair sits flat on the table saw. But because there is sometimes a little difference in the shape of this back leg and the way that this has been filed off, I have found it necessary to just put a small thin washer in there. And that levels the chair. I've only had to do that on two chairs. Taking note of where that washer is, I want it to be on the section of the leg that was filed off. Four glides installed. No wiggle. Sitting dead flat on the table saw.